We'll discuss one more concept called incenter and excenter. Now, let us see, consider a triangle ABC. Now, this is triangle A, B, C. Suppose the coordinates are given by AX1, Y1, BX2, Y3, CX3, Y3. Now, assume that the lengths of the sides are denoted by A comma B comma C. That means BC length is A, CA length is B, AB length is C. Now, you know that this is angle A and this is angle B, this is angle C. Now, if you draw an angular bisector like this, this need not be the midpoint of the base. In the same fashion, you can draw one more angular bisector and one more angular bisector. Now, you are able to see one point here, I. This is the point of concurrence of internal angular bisectors of the angles of a triangle. I repeat, this is the internal point of concurrence of internal angular bisectors of the angles of a triangle. Since three angles are there, three angular bisectors are there. That point of concurrence is called incenter, denoted by I. So, incenter is given by the formula, this is AX1 plus BX2 plus CX3 divided by A plus B plus C comma AY1 plus BY2 plus CY3 by A plus B plus C. How you will get these coordinates in vector algebra, you will come to know about this one, the derivation of incenter like this model. Now you are able to see very clearly x1, x2, x3, x1, x2, y1, y2, x3, y3 are called the vertices of a triangle, whereas small letters a comma b comma c are the lengths of the sides of a triangle. Now you observe that this is the incenter. Now give the names D, E, F. Now AD is called internal angular bisector, BE is called one more internal angular bisector, CF is called third internal angular bisector. We have standard result, every internal bisector, every angular bisector divides the opposite side in the ratio of its adjacent sides. That means AD divides BC in the ratio of its adjacent sides, that is C is to B. So we will write AD divides BC in what ratio? C is to B. In the same fashion, BE divides next CA in what ratio? Now for BE, the adjacent sides are A and C. So this is A is to C. Then comes CF divides next AB in. Now you can see this is B and A. So B is to A. So every internal angular bisector divides the opposite side in the ratio of its adjacent sides. One more property is there. That is, the incenter will divide every internal angular bisector. That means I divides AD in some ratio. That ratio is nothing but, now this part is nothing but sum of these two. This is B plus C and this is A. So we can write I divides AD in what ratio? B plus C is to A. In the same fashion, I divides BE also. I divides BE in, you observe for BE, what is the total one? C plus A. This is C plus A and B. So C plus A is to B. Then I divides CF in, you can see cyclic order, B, C, A, C, A, B. Then now comes A plus B is to C. Even if you want, you can derive this particular formula from this only. Now I is an internal point for these two. And how to find out D? Let us see. Now D coordinates are nothing but D is a point on BC which divides BC in what ratio C is to B. Formula CX3 internally, come on, CX3 plus BX2 divided by B plus C. Then comes CY3 plus BY2 divided by B plus C. Now we got AX1, Y1. We observe that I divides AD in B plus C is to A. So we wrote like this. Therefore I is equal to, now you write A into X1, A into X1 plus B plus C into X coordinate of D. So here B plus C into X coordinate CX3 plus BX2 divided by B plus C. B plus C, B plus C gets cancelled, divided by, this is our internal formula, MX2 plus NX1 by M plus N, that is A plus B plus C. In the same fashion, Y coordinate also. This is again A into Y1, A into Y1 plus B plus C into CY3 plus BY2 divided by C plus B divided by A plus B plus C. So gets cancelled, ultimately leaving AX1 BX2 plus CX3 by A plus B plus C comma AY1 plus BY2 plus CY3 divided by A plus B plus C. Now we got derivation of this incenter coordinates from this ratio.